10, as we mentioned, Chinese President Xi Jinping, apologies there, Vladimir Putin from Russia, Bolsonaro from Brazil, and Scott Morrison, of course, from Australia. So how would this be deemed a success? Tom Burke was a government advisor on climate change, as chairman and founding director of E3G, with me now. Okay, Hal, what, going in realistically, what do you hope could be achieved? Good morning.
Well, what I hope can be achieved is that we get a significant increase in the ambition of people's national commitments, national targets to deal with climate change, that we get enough money out of the $100 billion that has been promised for a long time now, committed to help the emerging economies deal with climate change, and we get an end to coal, a commitment from countries to put an end to the use of coal. That's what I'm hoping for. I'm not sure we're going to get all of that, but we're certainly there's certainly going to be a big effort made to try and achieve that.
How relevant, how troubled are you by the fact that you won't, it would appear, you won't have the leaders of countries such as China and Brazil around the table?
Well, I don't know that we won't have those people around the table. It would be very damaging if China didn't come. The whole global regime for dealing with climate change basically stands on an axis of the US, China, and the EU. And if China doesn't come, that foundation starts to fall apart.
When you say China, do you mean President Xi, or do you mean just a Chinese representative?
No, I mean President Xi. You're quite right. Right. He has to come, or effectively China's not there. So you're quite right about that. But I don't know that he's not coming. All we've got is an unsourced story in the Times promoting this, and well, there have been more of those in the Times, so I'm not sure that that's actually going to be the case. It would be very damaging, not just, by the way, to climate change and to Britain and the Prime Minister's aims to get British leadership recognised, but also to China. China is probably got the most exposed economy to a failure of climate policy. All of those exports that come to us from China that we get so worried about sometimes come essentially from low-lying eastern China, which is really subject to very damaging effects of climate change.
We're having this conversation, lastly, because some of the Queen's comments have been picked up, yeah. Mr. Burke. It's really irritating, she says, when they talk but they don't do. That, to me, seems a fair summation. Would you agree?
I completely agree with that, and it doesn't just apply to other leaders, it applies to our own leaders as well. I think it's quite interesting to see how united the royal family is on this. I can't remember a time when they've all spoken out in one way or another on an issue. And she's quite right, of course, because Australia, I think you're a correspondent was wrong. Australia is actually one of the worst performers on climate change, and that's widely recognized, yes, everywhere. So the real threat to a failure in COP is not, and again, to everything, but for the Queen's point of view, this would really be damaging to the Commonwealth. I mean, the Commonwealth is full of people who will be real losers if climate policy fails, and I think the royal family understand that very well.
Been good speaking with you, Tom Burke. You were former government advisor on climate change. You're chairman and founder director of E3G. Thank you for your input. What